You know, it does look more and more like we may not see too much of Matthew.
Yeah, but it's been real difficult as far as the forecast models, 4 and 5 days out especially. Mm-hmm. But now things are starting to come together, and I think we're going to be fine out of this. We're not likely to see anything big, even for the Outer Banks, even for Hatteras and Ocracoke. I think we're going to be fine with that. So we can look at this thing, breathe a little bit easier. We don't need this. Here's a look at what's going on. Latest on Hurricane Matthew, and this is from the 5 p.m. update this afternoon from the Hurricane Center. And this has really been going along now, and the trend is continuing to push this thing a little bit to the south of us, well to the south of us, so as not to really bother us whatsoever. The eye is kind of filled in this afternoon. They're the nighttime pictures. They're kind of blocky, and then the daytime pictures, we get higher resolution. But the eye is filled in just a little bit. You can see some of the bumpy cloud cover with this, but nonetheless, it is out there over the southern Bahamas, out in the open water. And once it's in the open water, it's bathwater out there, and that's what fuels the whole situation, is that warm, steamy water. And again, that's what's going on with it. 120 mile an hour winds. It was over eastern Cuba last night, and that slowed it down a little bit. It was 130, 140 miles an hour, and of course 160 miles an hour last weekend. Here's where it is as of 5 o'clock. We're going to take you through time. Thursday morning, in other words, overnight, it's a category 3 storm, 125 miles an hour. It bumped up just a little bit. There's where it is by tomorrow afternoon. 130 mile an hour winds. Now category 4. It's bumped up a little bit more. Now it's there's where Miami is right there. We'll go in a little bit tighter, show you what's going on by Thursday night, Friday morning. 130 mile an hour winds approaching the shoreline. Now the Hurricane Forecast Center, National Hurricane Center. Again, the track. This is the admission of forecast error right here. It could be toward the Orlando area as a weaker storm. It could be a little bit farther out to sea as a little bit stronger storm. Right now, they've got it right on in over Cape Canaveral. The worst part of the storm is on the eastern side of that storm, and I'll show you more on that coming up at 5:30. So again, they're still going to get socked very, very heavily out of this storm. West side of the storm is the better part of the storm, where obviously most of the population lives, but there are a lot of barrier islands, lots of condos, lots of places to live along there, and they could really, really get raked over the coals. There's where things are at 7 o'clock on Saturday morning. There's Jacksonville, there's Savannah right there, there's Charleston. By Saturday afternoon at 2 o'clock, 105 mile an hour winds. And then it starts curving to the east and even to the southeast. Coming up by Sunday afternoon, 90 mile an hour winds. And there's where it is by Monday at 2 o'clock, 75 mile an hour winds. Forecast models, again, have not been consistent in the long, long run, but we want to show you what's going on with them. There's where things are by Sunday morning, and then they just kind of go crazy as far as what they're going to do with this thing. But the general consensus is to drift it around out into here and then have it fall apart. I'm going to show you this one more time. It's kind of fun. Get a little more time to show you what's going on with it. There's where this forecast model takes it, pretty close to where the Hurricane Center's track is, 1 o'clock in the morning on Friday. Now it takes it on inland, just inland of Fort Pierce, remembering that the worst part of any storm is just immediately to the right of the eye. So they could really get pounded on some of these areas. And again, these are barrier islands all along here with a lot of condos on them. And there's where we are to the east of Orlando into the Cocoa Beach, Florida area. There's Cape Canaveral right on into here. That's at noon coming up day after tomorrow on Friday. Moves it on up through Daytona, on up toward Jacksonville by the nighttime hours, Friday night, Saturday morning at 2 o'clock in the morning. It's still getting raked over the coals farther northward on even towards Savannah. And then it starts popping offshore once it gets anywhere near Savannah. There's where things are by 3 in the afternoon on Saturday. There's where we are by 11 o'clock at night on Saturday. And there's where we are again by Sunday evening. It's bumped well on out to sea. By the way, Tropical Storm Nicole is out into here too, but again, that's not going to do anything. I want to show you what's going on for us. We take where we started with that whole picture, and we're going to start things off with, I'll show you where we are. Midnight hour, we're going to go on through Friday, show you what's going on with our forecast. Here's where we are, 7 o'clock on Thursday morning. Tomorrow morning, 3 in the afternoon, 71, 72. There's where we are by 7 o'clock on Friday morning, 68, 71. And a little bit better chance of some rain coming up during the afternoon hours of Friday. There's where we are by Friday evening at 7 o'clock. So what do we got going on out there right now? It's the same stuff. Cloudy, lots of cloud cover, a little bit of a breeze through the trees, and that, of course, has popped up our tides. Tomorrow morning, overnight, 4.4, 4.5, 4.1, 4.1. These are not as a result of Matthew, so we're going to see nuisance to minor tidal flooding coming up over the next couple of days. But I think we're going to be okay with this. We're going to see some drizzle, some scattered light rain, a little bit more of a breeze. Breezy early in the day on Sunday. Temperatures generally into the 70s, a couple of readings even into the 60s by Sunday and Monday. We'll have more on Matthew. We're going to start focusing on our weather, too, our nicer weather. That'll be coming up at 5:30.